cost-efficient manner. The recruitment process includes analyzing the requirements of a job, attracting employees to that job, screening and selecting applicants, hiring and integrating the new employee into the organization. The role of HR recruitment is to build a supply of potential new hires to meet organizational needs. Why recruit? You can recruit because of the loss of an existing employee, a decision to enter a new market, or the growth of a business. The process includes developing a pool of minimally acceptable candidates for each open position while controlling costs, meeting the organization's legal and social obligations related to the workforce. Some alternatives could be to train the existing staff to develop competencies, redesign work schedules so work is redistributed between existing staff, drop particular product or service lines if they're not of strategic importance, or subcontract or outsource the relevant functions. Who to recruit? Recruit for attitude, train for aptitude. Skills and knowledge can be taught. Attitude comes from within. Prospective employees should embody the values and vision of the organization starting from the vision or mission statement. Pick out important character traits. These can come from the personality profile. Some different methods of human resource recruitment include job postings, word of mouth, advertising media, walk-ins, campus or university recruitment, job fairs and open houses, government agencies, radio, television, and also the internet. And it could also include like on Facebook, Twitter, and like social media and others. A job posting, this is the process by which internal recruitment is accomplished. The standard time for a job posting is a period of between 1 or 2 weeks. This could be found in various places like online or in a newspaper or in social media. And Anthony will go over this more in detail later on in the presentation. Job specifications. These are derived from the job description. Job specifications include responsibilities involved, outcomes sought, hours of work, form and frequency of appraisal, businesses, and bonuses and benefits. And Craig will also go more into detail on this later on in the presentation. Personnel specifications. These are skills or qualifications necessary to perform the role. Relevant experience required, personality traits that can be taken from a personality profile previously drawn up, other important information as necessary. The specification should be derived from the job description and forms the foundation for the recruitment process. Shortlisting. Shortlisting is the process of selecting those candidates who seem most suitable for the position. Candidates may be either interviewed, required to demonstrate some further skills or aptitude, asked to provide further details in support of their application, and it's about whom you want to find out more about in the final formal interview. To select for interview, only those candidates who fulfill the necessary criteria, preferably 2 to 3 candidates for any single position, use other information given to make selection like skills, personal qualities, and experience. This could be done not just by the HR management, but also by a selection committee. Interviewing. The aim of a job interview is to allow the candidate to demonstrate their ability to do the job. Interviews are generally the best way of judging whether a candidate will fit into the organization's culture. Remember that interviews work both ways. Interviews gather information about an applicant, present a realistic description of the position, and ensure a fair selection process. Some good recruiter traits are being a good listener, a clear communicator, a sense of urgency, timing, patience, and quick strike capabilities, being able to sort through mounds of data and finding the key factors, being able to motivate and support, and how to extend offer and close the deal. New. I worked at a New York Sports Club for the past couple of summers by May. For the recruitment process for becoming a welcome team, which is the front desk, you have to be a people person, and during the interview, they ask you a bunch of personality questions so they know if you're a fit. Like when I got interviewed, my general manager told me that I had a bubbly personality, so I'd be great for working the front desk. And basically what I love to do is every day, you just know the members by their first name, so I would greet them. I knew if they wanted towels, I'll ask, I knew what classes they wanted, and I was just able to have a good relationship with the members of the gym. And also when they're leaving the gym, you say goodbye. You just do a lot of personal things that your personality really depends on that job. And then also, recently my sister was just covering maternity leave. so her experience helped her get the maternity leave, and now they also just recently hired her for the upcoming year to be a full-time teacher. So her experience really helped her get her job, and she's able to like have a full-time job now instead of just covering the maternity leave. And next up is Craig. He'll be going over the job specifications and job analysis.
My name is Craig Germanario, talking about the job specifications from job analysis. What is a job analysis? Job analysis is the study of jobs to determine what activities and responsibilities they include and their importance compared to other jobs, the personal qualifications necessary for performance of the job, and the condition under which the work is performed. An important concept in job analysis is that an evaluation is conducted of the job and not of the person doing the job. Job analysis is the procedure through which we determine the duties, roles, and responsibilities of these positions and the characteristic skills and knowledge of the people to hire for them. Job analysis produces information used for writing job descriptions and job specifications. It is usually documented through what is called a job analysis questionnaire. What is a job description? It's a broad, general, and written statement of a specific job based on the findings of a job analysis. It generally includes the duties, purpose, responsibilities, scope, working conditions of a job, along with the job's title and the name of the employee, of whom the employee reports to. Job descriptions form the basis of job specifications. Uses for job analysis, descriptions, and specifications. It can be used for a number of things, such as workforce planning, organizational design, performance management, affirmative action plans, recruiting and selection, career and succession planning, training and development, compensation administration, health and safety, employee relations, and compliance with legal requirements. Job specifications are formed from the job description. The job specification is the statement of the essential components of a job class, including a summary of the work to be performed, primary duties and responsibilities, and the minimum qualifications and requirements necessary to perform the essential functions of the job. The difference between a job specification and job description: a job description entails the job title, the hours they will work, their duties and responsibilities, working conditions, and salary and incentives, while job specification is more about the necessary qualifications, the qualities, experience, training, and interpersonal skills that are required for the job. Purpose for a job specification. Job specifications help candidates analyze whether or not they are eligible to apply for a particular job. Also, it helps the recruiting team of an organization understand what level of qualifications, qualities, and characteristics should be in a particular candidate to make them eligible for the job. Advantages of a job specification: they are helpful in the preliminary screening and selection procedure. It also helps in giving due justification for each job, and it helps in the designing and of training and development programs. It helps the supervisors for counseling and monitoring performance of their employees. More advantages of job specifications are: they help the management also make decisions regarding promotion, transfers, and giving away extra benefits to their employees, and they help in selecting the most appropriate candidate for a particular job. As you can see, having a job specification not only helps prospective applicants, but it helps the management too. Now I'm going to go into detail about the different components of a job specification. First one is education. The job specification will talk about the required education needed for the job, whether you need a college degree, master's degree, or PhD. For some jobs, they may even talk about exactly which majors that they're looking for. Next is the experience. Most jobs are looking for applicants that have some experience in the field for which they are applying, whether it be an internship, another job, or even volunteer work in the field. For example, if you're applying to be a teacher, it may say something like having 4 years of experience in an educational program in a school or other educational institution. Next is special attributes or skills. Special attributes and skills section talks about the skills that they are looking for in a particular candidate. Some examples may be being good with computers and proficient in Microsoft Word, PowerPoint, Excel, or something like how many words per minute you could type, or good interpersonal, written, or communication skills. Next is the physical and mental attributes. Certain jobs have a section requiring certain physical and mental abilities. For example, a job specification for a construction worker might say something like be able to lift at least 50 pounds, climb ladders, lift, walk or stand for long periods of time. Job specification for a nurse might say something like being able to deal with constantly changing high-stress situations. This is a sample of a job analysis questionnaire. That's how the job analysis was derived from. In this example, the questionnaire asks things like what the job title is, the supervisor's title, the name, the department the job's in, who it was prepared by, hours worked, and the general purpose for the job. This is a sample of a job description for a cashier at a bookstore. It talks about the main duties and responsibilities, such as operating cash register, answering customer questions, receiving, stocking, pricing merchandise, and assisting with merchandise purchasing and processing returns of books and magazines. It's just letting you know exactly what to expect in the job. This is a sample of a job specification. This one is for a preschool teacher. For the skills and attributes section, it lists skills and qualities needed, such as compassion, good planning skills, flexibility, excellent team building skills, superior verbal and written skills, patience, excellent supervisory skills, and superior stress management skills. New and used, I currently work as a server at Ruby Tuesday. I pulled one of their server job descriptions up online, and it's broken down into four categories: job summary, essential duties and responsibilities, education and experience, and the physical requirements. For one example of this is it requires a high school diploma or GED equivalent. They also require you to adhere to the dress policy, maintaining a friendly personality and attitude, guide guests through food, drink, and promotional menus, assist guests with any questions, and serve food and beverages from Ruby Tuesday standards. The physical requirement says you must be able to stand for long periods of time and carry items in excess of 50 pounds. Up next is Jeremy with Company Image.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Jeremy, and I'm going to tell you all about company image and, more importantly, how a company's image relates to human resources and the recruitment process. A company image, which is commonly known as a corporate image, refers to what the public is supposed to see when the corporation is mentioned. A positive company image can lead to a company making more money, stand out from the competition, and have a high rate of customer satisfaction. When developing this image, it's important that the company first has well-defined values and goals. In order to create a strong company image, a corporation must build brand awareness. Brand awareness is the extent to which consumers are familiar with the distinctive qualities or image of a particular brand of goods or services. Brand awareness is key when promoting for the company and trying to reach a large audience. There are multiple ways that a company can build on this brand awareness, and the most important part is knowing what demographic that you are targeting. Key areas can be broken down into the social media sphere, the global sphere, and the local sphere. By using social media, a company can actively engage with their audience, find out exactly who their audience is, and reach millions of people using analytics tools to track the website usage. Globally, larger corporations can use social media and other tools to contact clients and customers around the world. By doing this, it is important to understand the differences between cultures and tailor the message to each group. Locally, building meaningful connections with the very known members of the community and physically visiting these types of people with a selfless attitude is key. Image has a very strong effect on the public audience. Scandals, lawsuits, and conversely, social outreach programs and fundraisers can be some of the most important things that a company can engage in that affect sales. People watch the news, people talk with others, and often this gets most of the people's attention. A negative image can completely ruin the livelihood of the company, even if the company fulfills their consumer needs. Take SeaWorld for an example. After the tarnishing Blackfish documentary, the company's stock has tumbled 33%. Target is another example. Stock has tumbled 8% after the recent credit card hack on their company. A positive image will drive a company's success. Advertisements and promotions that play off the customer's wants, reach them at a personal level, and make them feel good emotions will drive up sales. So how does this relate to recruiting? Recruiters need to keep in mind all of the major points which I outlined and view their candidates as if they were customers they were trying to sell to. So let's look at the recruitment process in terms